I am under the belief that dark energy and dark matter are both caused by the solar system's orbit around an undiscovered black hole partner to the sun. My name is Demian, and this is Growing Together. In this video, I'm going to talk about 8 predictions that the Matthew hypothesis makes that we will observe in the near future. It's February 22nd, 2023. These predictions are bold, and if they don't happen, the Matthew hypothesis is incorrect. I have been pursuing this idea for 18 years. Every hypothesis must have predictions. If all 8 predictions turn out to be true, it will be solid evidence that our observations that led us to believe in dark energy and dark matter are actually caused by the solar system's orbit around an undiscovered black hole partner. Prediction number 1. The Hubble constant will increase over time. It's not a constant. It's actually caused by the perceived redshift we observe as participants in this binary orbit. Today, the rate of accelerated expansion is measured at 73 kilometers per second per megaparsec. This rate will increase over time and will continue to increase until the sun reaches periapsis. Prediction number 2. The age of our universe will also increase over time as we measure it again and again in the future. Today, it's at 13.7 billion years. Tomorrow, it's going to be older. The same reason as prediction 1, it dominoes from prediction 1. Prediction number 3. Our measurements of cosmic microwave background will also change over time. This one is going to be extremely difficult to explain away if we hold on to the idea that dark matter exists. Within cosmic microwave background, we find an indirect measurement to what is considered dark matter. Cosmic microwave background are just photons, which are also affected by local Doppler effects and possibly the gravitational field that we as observers are subjected to in this binary orbit. Prediction number 4. The motion that we observe, known as precession of the equinoxes, will be observed from any other location outside of the Earth's gravitational field and within our solar system. We can check that today. If the sun is in a binary orbit, the effects of precession are not caused by a wobbling Earth. We can actually disprove the Matthew hypothesis today if we simply take a look and see if we measure precession from Mars or Saturn or Jupiter. If we observe precession of the equinoxes from any place in our solar system outside of the Earth's gravitational field, this would prove that the sun is in a binary orbit, and we can nail the coffin on Newton's lunisolar wobble theory, which is scientific dogma today. Prediction number 5. The rate of expansion of all the planetary orbits around the sun will continue to increase gradually over time. This one's kind of a cheat because we already observed that, but we attribute it to the sun losing mass because of fusion. That makes sense, but it's not the only cause. The sun's black hole partner would also be pulling on the sun and the planets, but slightly more on the sun because of its greater mass. This will cause all the orbits around the sun to slightly increase over time as they trail behind the sun, so to speak. Prediction number 6. We will continue to observe and discover more and more complex planetary systems in binary star systems, challenging our long-held and established views about planet formation in our solar system. In my research paper, I reference recent simulation studies showing how planetary orbits can remain stable even at a distance of 3 astronomical units from another star. Using the binary orbit of Alpha Centauri as our guide, which is the closest star to our sun, and also a binary star system. Prediction number 7. We will never directly observe dark matter or discover any theoretical particle for it. And also, the same goes for dark energy. The cause of our observations of dark energy and dark matter are local gravitational forces acting on us as observers and perfectly explained within general relativity. Prediction number 8. I saved the best for last. The amount of dark matter will increase over time. That's another one that's going to be hard to explain away. We're not going to only observe the orbital speeds of galaxies and galaxy clusters to increase over time, but we will also measure an increase of the indirect measurement within cosmic microwave background of what we consider dark matter. If the Matthew hypothesis continues to be ignored by them, they're going to present modified gravity theories to replace dark matter, but they're still gonna seriously miss the boat unless they realize that gravity is actually being modified locally by our proximity and acceleration towards this black hole partner. It's not Puff the Magic Dragon out there in the universe, which is what I consider galaxy halos to be, and it's not any gravitational laws of physics we have not yet discovered. Gravity is being modified from our relative point of view as observers, because the Sun is in orbit around an undiscovered black hole partner. The solar system's acceleration towards periapsis and the gravitational field of this black hole partner are the cause of our time dilation and redshift observations attributed to dark matter and dark energy. However, there is good news. Jesus Christ forewarned us about this 2,000 years ago. It is what Christ said in Matthew 24:29 that put this idea in my head 18 years ago when I was studying black holes. For me, this is indirect evidence that Christ is God. Whether the Matthew hypothesis is correct or incorrect, that's not what's most important. How to courageously be a good person is what's most important. If you belong to God, not our discoveries, not our science, not our careers, not our accomplishments. Being a good person is what it's about. We don't have to be smart for that. We have to have intention for that. Faith helps, and you've done the right thing, and persecution hits you. Faith really helps in those moments. I'm like DiCaprio in Don't Look Up, but I'm not stressing out like him. Yes, the idea came from a revelation or faith or whatever, but the paper is scientific, so I hope that you don't check it off simply because I talk about these things, or because I believe that the Sun is not going to make it around the bend this time. That's just my faith, and it's different from the science. Thanks for watching. Be good to each other, be good to yourselves, and I'll see you next time.